Welcome to LINAK's Actuator Academy video series for industrial actuators. I'm Hunter, and in this episode, we'll talk about how housings for LINAK actuators are designed according to the actuator's performance, and what features are added to ensure the ingress protection and quality of a LINAK actuator. A housing is normally made of two shells that are tightened together around the actuator's internal components. LINAK's actuator housings are made of one of two types of materials, plastic or aluminum. Actuators with plastic housings are very suitable for use in a wide range of machinery. However, in cases of frequent temperature fluctuations, the plastic relaxes and the ingress protection of the actuator can decrease over time. In such cases, an industrial actuator with an aluminum housing would be the best solution. A housing made from aluminum maintains its form in spite of fluctuating temperatures, chemicals, or other harsh environments, offering a high IP degree that doesn't diminish over time. This is why some LINAK industrial actuators have housings made from this material, which is perfect for use in harsh environments. In order to document an industrial actuator's compliance with the mentioned requirements, a dunk test is often performed to ensure ingress protection under a wide range of conditions. Aside from the material benefits of using aluminum instead of plastic, the design of the housing also plays a major role for an actuator's resistance towards harsh environments. The aluminum housing can be designed either with an aluminum back fixture as part of the housing or with a hole for the standard steel back fixture as seen here. If a housing is designed with an integrated back fixture, the push and pull forces will move through the actuator spindle into the ball bearing at the end and from there continue to the back fixture and the housing. This type of housing design is normally used for actuators that push or pull less than 1,000 newtons, since higher loads in combination with vibrations can damage the housing and reduce the actuator's ingress protection. Actuators that handle higher loads are designed to lead the force through the spindle and directly into a steel back fixture so that the housing is not directly exposed to the force and will be more resistant towards vibrations. Typically, an actuator's housing is designed to cover components and protect the integrated electronics. But to LINAK, it's also very important that actuators have a clean industrial design and look good. So in some cases, housings are modified to ensure a sleek look and provide great aesthetics for the end result. Each of LINAK's heavy-duty industrial actuators can be recognized by their familiar design. They have a rustic, dark gray aluminum housing, extruded anodized outer tubes, polished stainless steel inner tubes, and are all IP69K approved. Harsh environment and ingress protection has never been more important for LINAK industrial actuators than it is now. One reason is that many LINAK actuators have integrated electronics, which must be protected against various harsh environments. Because of this, actuators designed for harsh environments include several features that help ensure their durability and IP degree. For example, when an actuator runs in and out, a vacuum is created inside the actuator, and if the air is moist and is cooled down, small drops of water could enter the actuator. Therefore, integrated LINAK PCBs with H-bridges are coated to ensure that a drop of water or moisture will not create an unintended actuator movement. Also, LINAK's heavy-duty industrial actuators are designed with a polished inner tube to ensure that almost no moisture enters the actuator. If you were to use an unpolished inner tube, moisture or water could form in the microscopic irregularities of the tube and eventually end up inside the actuator. For harsh environment actuators, the design of the aluminum housings support the ability to easily exchange a cable in case it is damaged, without compromising the actuator's IP degree. The cork sealing that LINAK uses for its heavy-duty actuators has also been used by the car industry for many years. It's very suitable for demanding environments where actuators are exposed to extreme temperatures, corrosive chemicals, salt, water, dust, you name it. For LINAK actuators that are ATEX and IECEX certified for zones 21 and 22, meaning that they are approved for use in explosive environments, a special cork sealing is used to ensure the right ingress protection under very high temperatures. For special environments such as kitchens, where hygiene is of great importance, it is possible to choose a silicone sealing for the actuator so that bacteria can't get stuck on the smooth surface of the actuator or the ceiling. Finally, the surface of harsh environment housings are corrosion treated. These housings are tested to withstand 500 hours of salt spray, along with multiple other obligatory harsh environment tests. in case an actuator will be in contact with extremely corrosive liquids or vapors such as ammonia, it is recommended to choose an anodized housing for your actuator. This is common when an actuator is placed on salt or fertilizer spreaders or in stable ventilation systems. To obtain this property, this type of housing is first anodized and then painted black, a distinguishing characteristic of this housing over the standard. So that's all for now. We hope you enjoyed our video about actuator housings and how their design, robustness, and IP degree influence an actuator's quality and performance. If you have any questions about housings for electric linear actuators, please feel free to contact your local LINAK office. Thank you for watching.